On Target is brought to you by First National Bank.
Hi, and welcome to another episode of On Target. My name is Mami Gyemfua. Special thanks to First National Bank for coming on board. Let's talk about Hearts of Oak. It is not exactly happy times at the club at the moment. The Phobians' form has been undulating and are by far one of the most inconsistent teams in the league. They have managed to slump against teams they are expected to blow away and have not performed to their utmost best in most of the wins they have collected. A perfect example is the win they picked up in Dansoman, where they came from a goal down to win. It sparked so much joy amongst fans then, but it seems like a long time ago now. Put the Hearts form into perspective, they have only won 4 matches out of the 12, which is not a hard standard, and have not won a back-to-back game all season. After the draw against Ejana, the Phobians have played Bechim, Karela and Elmina Sharks, which have marched down as relatively easy fixtures, but have picked up 5 points from a possible 12 at stake. The draw against the Sharks on Sunday was particularly shattering for the coach and fans. Hearts need to climb up the table now and fast. In order to do that, they have to win games, and that has unfortunately looked like a luxury this season. There is fire on the mountain and we can only wait to see how it unfolds. Now to Kotoko. After a torrid 2 weeks, the Porcupines are back winning again. They beat Bechim United 3-1 in their newly adopted home ground, the Accra Sports Stadium, a ground they seem very comfortable on. They have won every game there this season and are looking to build on. If they win the league while playing in Accra, maybe they can change their club's name. Accra Asante Kotoko. Maybe.
Kotoko, that was a good ball in. Goalkeeper had to step off his line and get something on it. The Chairman United are up by 1-0. Moro sends a good cross at the bar. Equalizer. Imoro sends a decent cross in. Again, Kotoko. They get a second goal. 5 meters. Moro!
Now, how many times will league leaders go to the ground and get wallowed? 6-1? Well, Ashanti Gold went to Sogakope to play Wafa, hoping to black them out and hold out for a draw, or in the event of good luck, a 1-0 win. In the end, they were beaten 6-1 by the Academy boys, who are no respecter of teams who come to their grounds. Man, that will take some recovering from Ashgold. The Ghana Premier League has been very exciting, and it keeps us wanting more and more every time. Match day 13 should be exciting. After the 6-1, Ashgold are heading to Ejana. Kotoko play Carols in Takwa, Hearts play Inter Allies in Accra, and Great Olympics, who are hitting relegation numbers, play fellow relegation counterparts, Dwarves. Let's head to Europe now, shall we? In England, there was a familiar sight, Man City winning another trophy. Last season, they bagged the domestic treble. This time, they have won the Carabao Cup locked down and still in the race for the FA Cup. But their latest triumph was far from straightforward. Villa gave them a tough run for it, and even Pep Guardiola admitted to it at the end of the game. City are in tough times. Saddled with court cases, a ban from the Champions League, and a long list of injuries hitting key players, but the cup win gives them some joy.
Carabao Cup 2020!
A cue to say that in tough times, one could crack a smile. City will try to run Liverpool close, but that looks impossible now. The Reds are 22 points clear even after losing, and they will not sit to lose any more points. Klopp wants a statement win this season, and that's all his sights are set on. Meanwhile, the race for the champion spot remains open in England, with no club able to take a strong hold of it. Liverpool and Manchester City seem to have wrapped it up, but with Leicester struggling, Tottenham and Chelsea out of form, and Man United inconsistent, Wolves and Sheffield United are all finally poised to take advantage. This weekend, there's a London debut involving Arsenal and West Ham, Wolves play Brighton, Chelsea play Everton at the Bridge, and there's a mouth-watering Manchester derby at Old Trafford. So what do you think about Barcelona now? Be sincere. The club used to be one of the best-run clubs in the world. But after a few signings and over-reliance on Messi, are they still the best-run club? Look at how they got Martin Braithwaite in. Are Barcelona saying there's no kid at La Masia who could have come in to hold the fort for Suarez? After the kid in the Clasico though, they will be looking to make amends. The Spanish title race this season could be the best we have seen in a while. Now, the well-dreaded coronavirus disease that is somewhat killing the game that we love. Last weekend, many games in Italy were cancelled due to concerns of how quickly it could spread in the big public space, like the stadium. Italy, that toll of the virus keeps rising, and to keep it in check, measures need to be taken, and avoiding games is one of them. It's strange, this coronavirus. We are also hearing that it could affect the Euro 2020 and even the Olympic Games, which is set to be staged in Tokyo. The local organizing committee have sent out several strongly worded statements to the Olympic Committee about a possible postponement. Hopefully, it doesn't come to that and things get better. We cannot lose more people and the games need to be enjoyed by everyone. Now, let's take a look at what's happening at the Black Stars front. This week marked the first time the new Ghana coach, CK Akono, met with the media. His first media interaction coincided with his first squad announcement too, but it didn't generate as much conversation as the ones that has been done already in the past. Akono selected four local players into the new fold. Yaya Mohamed of Ejana Stars, who scored 10 goals in 12 games in the Ghana Premier League, Kwejo Amwako, the Ashanti Gold right back, Habib Mohamed of Kotoko and Hearts goalkeeper Richard, who have racked more clean sheets than the Phobians have wins this season. Eugene Ansah and Tariq Fosu come in as some of the new boys to make the squad. Ansah has scored 3 goals in 25 games in Israel, and his inclusion has raised many eyebrows, but Akono has justified this reason for selecting him. Hopefully, he proves his naysayers wrong in the games ahead of us. Old boys Pate, the Ayew brothers, Wakaso and Alfred Duncan are all in the squad. The biggest surprise though is Jonathan Mensah's omission from the squad. There have been many questions. The jury is out. Akono would only have to convince us of how good his players are on the pitch. Cheers, Akono. This has been another episode of On Target with me, Mami Gyemfua. See you same time next week. Cheers.
On Target was brought to you by First National Bank.